Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is another Halloween tutorial and this is on this easy to do vampire look. So let's get started. So I'm going to start with skin and I'm going to prime my skin with the Stila One Step Crypt Primer. So as I mentioned before in a couple of videos, I don't actually like that primer that much. I just wanted to use it up. And then I'm following that up with the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. And I am in the shade 1.5, I believe. So I'm just blending that into my skin using a flat top buffing brush from Rue Techniques. So I've never actually used this foundation on my channel before, but I have been testing it out and I quite like it. So now onto concealer, I'm using the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Concealer in the shade R250 and I'm also using this as my eye primer today. It's the shade R20, not R250, that is the shade that I'm in the foundation. I always get confused with that, but it's R20, that is the lightest shade this concealer comes in. And I'm just blending that in with a Zoeva Concealer Buffer Brush. So I'm just blending this underneath the eyes and over my eyelid as well. So I just want to pre-warn you a little bit, the lighting's going to change really dramatically like it just did there in this video because it was really kind of bright but the sun kept going away when I was filming this, so I'm really sorry about that. But I'm just baking underneath my eyes with the RCMA No Colour Powder as usual with one of the Rue Techniques Medical Eraser Sponges, I think they're called. So I'm just packing this on underneath my eyes to bake and set my concealer. And I'm also patting a little bit of this powder on top of my eyelid just to set that concealer and prime my eyes for shadow. So after a couple of minutes, I'm just dusting off that bake underneath my eyes and it's ready to go in with some shadow. So first I'm going in with the shade Friendzone from Makeup Geek and I'm taking this on a Sigma E40 brush, I believe, or is it E35? Yeah, it's E35, so that's a tapered blending brush, so I'm just using this to buff it into the crease. I'm taking it really high up and kind of blown it out. Next I'm getting in with the shade Wild West, which is one of the newer fall shades from Makeup Geek. So I'm taking that on the same brush, I'm just kind of buffing that out and then taking an E40 also from Sigma with no product on it just to blend out the edges. And I'm just going back in again with more of that Wild West shade and just building up the intensity in the crease a little bit. And again, I'm taking that same Sigma E40 and just blending out the edges so there's no harsh lines or anything. I want this to be completely blended and blown out right, practically right up to the brow bone. So I'm just going back in with that Wild West shade and using it on a flat shader brush from Zoeva and just packing this all over the lid. I didn't want there to be any shimmer or anything in this look, so I'm keeping it very matte on the eyes. And then going in with the same E35 with no additional product, I'm just blending that into the crease colour that we've already laid down. Next I'm going in with the shade Vintage and I'm using this on an eye blender brush from Zoeva and I'm just buffing this into the crease and the outer corner of the eye just to add a little bit of depth and intensity to the look. And I'm just blending that in with the same Sigma E35 brush, which is my new favourite blending brush since I picked this up from Cult Beauty a couple of weeks ago. I love it. And again, blending everything out with a Sigma E40. Next, I'm going back in with Wild West, and I'm taking that on a Zoeva 224 brush and just buffing this under the lower lash line just to really smoke it out and make it look really intense. Then I'm also going in with a pencil brush, also from Zoeva, with the same shade, and just intensifying that colour just right underneath the lower lash line. I saw that Jamie Genevieve had used that brush to do her lower lash line, so this is the first time me trying it out, but I think my eye space is a little bit small for that, so that's why I went in with the pencil brush. But now I'm just going back in with that Sigma E35 and just kind of blending out the edges of everything. So now I'm contouring with the Makeup Geek Contour Powder in the shade Breakup. So I'm really doing a heavy contour for this look. I wanted to look very structured and but obviously still blended, which is why this brush is so great. But now I'm going back in with Wild West, and I'm taking that on a kind of fine liner brush from New Techniques just to draw some little veins underneath my eyes. So that's what I'm doing here. So for this, I took inspiration from the kind of Vampire Diaries kind of vampire, like when they have the little veins and the cracks underneath their eyes. I always think that looks really, really cool, so that's what I wanted to go for with this look. So now I'm going to mix some Vintage on the same brush and just kind of darken up a couple of those veins to make them look as lifelike as possible. And now I'm applying some mascara to my top and bottom lashes. I'm skipping the falsies today because I wanted to focus on the eyes and not make them too overly dramatic. For brows, I went for a really strong brow, so I used my Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade and then set that with clear brow gel. And now for the only bit of shimmer on my face, I'm highlighting my brow bone with Shimmer Shimmer from Makeup Geek. For lips, I thought a deep berry shade would look best with this look, so I went for Divine Wine from Maybelline. So this is one of their matte lipsticks and I love it for this time of year, but especially for this kind of look, it really looks amazing. But to add a little bit of dimension to the lips, I went in with Ruby Woo from MAC on a pencil brush and just kind of added that to the centre of the lips to make it look a bit more red rather than just a kind of dark berry shade. So just add some fangs and this look is complete. So I'm really happy that this tutorial turned out. I think that it's a great kind of last minute, not really have to think too much about it kind of costume idea. So yeah, so if you enjoy it, please give this video a thumbs up and I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys!